Hi everyone, Jeff here, just hanging out in my dining room, checking out the latest innovations from Mendix, Mendix Assist AI-assisted development. Let's check it out.
Okay, let's take a few moments to set the stage. I've got an order management app I'm building published to the Mendix Cloud for review. I've created this order history page enabling users to enter new orders, review, and change existing orders. On the page, there's an existing order for Kate Collins, but there's no detail even though I've added items to her order. When I click on the arrow on the order for Kate Collins, I'm taken to the order details page for this order. You can see I have two items in the order, but the total is still $0. If I click on the calculate button, nothing happens. Let's go into the Mendix web modeler to update the calculate button to compute the total order amount. Back in the modeler, I'm in design mode for the order history page. I'm going to click on the arrow and then navigate to the order detail page from the properties panel on the right side of the screen. What I'm going to do is create some logic, also known as a microflow, using Mendix Assist to calculate a new total order amount. I'll start by clicking on the calculate button. Over in the properties panel under events, I'll click on a microflow and create a new microflow. Let's call it calc total order and create it. We're transported to the microflow editor inside the web modeler, and the first thing I see is a greeting from the MX assistant and a blue dot sitting between the start and end points of the microflow. I'm going to mouse over the blue dot and observe how a bow tie appears in the circle. When I click on the dot, the assistant presents a list of recommendations for different activities based on the orders parameter automatically created with the microflow. The assistant reads the database schema in the app and sees the relationships the order object has with other data elements. Choosing the Retrieve All Order Lines recommendation at the bottom of the list will give me a list of all of the items in a given order. The MX assistant teaches me about the retrieve activity I picked up before I move on. For the next step in the microflow, I want to loop through and sum the price of the order line list. I see the word loop at the top and click on it. MX Assistant adds a loop with an iterator to go through each order line item, but that's not really what I want. So let's remove that and select the assistant again. This time I'll select the calculate the sum of the price of all order line items. Mendix Assist will create an aggregate list activity for me and tell me how it works. By the way, I can toggle these help messages on or off, but I've kept them on for the demo to show how Mendix Assist teaches you to think in no-code terms. The last thing I need to do is set the total amount to the new value. I'll ask the assistant what makes the most sense, and it's to modify the order. When I pick that option, there are some additional properties I need to fill out. I know I want to change the total price field in the database, so I'll pick that and then choose the sum price variable the MX assistant created for me. And there you have it. The MX assistant taught me how to build a microflow, working side by side with me throughout the process, and helped me complete the thought without any errors in the logic. Let's test the new functionality by republishing the app and then going back into the mobile preview. I'll click on the arrow for Kate's order, and now I'll test out the calculate button, and the amount updates properly. Super awesome!